I'm Tom, and today I'm going to show you how to use the PID autotune feature of the Marlin firmware. So, temperature control is one of the most crucial features of our 3D printers. While the earlier printers controlled the temperatures of the hot end and the heated bed by simply turning on the heat if the temperature was below the set point and turning it off if it was above, today's printers use a much more elegant approach to managing temperatures. Simply speaking, they determine how much power to send to the heater by looking at how far the current temperature is away from the set point, by looking at how long the temperature has been off from the set point, and also by looking at how fast the temperature is changing. These three factors make up the P proportional, I integral, and D differential terms of the PID loop. Now, the PID loop on its own is not an intelligent system. You need to tell it how much it should care about each of the P, I, and D terms by giving it a set of KP, KI, and KD values. Figuring those out by hand is pretty tedious and probably won't get you a PID loop that works well. So what the guys behind Marlin implemented is a feature called PID autotune, and it's an easy and effective way of giving you a set of KI, KP, and KD values that work. Let's try it out. To get started, you need to be using the Marlin firmware on your printer. You need a working hot end and or heated bed that has a thermistor that gives accurate readings, and you need a reprep host that gives you a command line view, which you can use to send custom commands. I'm using Octoprint for this, but for example, Prontoface is going to work just as well. So the basic command for autotune is M303. If you just send that one command without any options, it will tune your hot end number one for a temperature of 150 degrees Celsius. That will give you a somewhat usable set of values, but to get better ones, you can add two more options. One is S to tell autotune the temperatures you want to tune for. For example, S230 for a hot end that's going to print ABS, or S120 for a heated bed for ABS. The other option is C, as in Caesar, which tells autotune to run the tuning process a couple times in a row to improve the results with each pass. By default, it does 3 passes, but since they don't really take long, I'm going to use C10 for 10 passes. So let's try that out. I'll send M303, S230, C10. The hot end will heat up and then cool and heat again around the target temperature for 10 times. It will report back to you each time it has finished a pass and give you one set of PID tunings. When it's done, it will write back a final set of KP, KI, and KD values to you. You can temporarily set them until the next time you reset the printer by using M301. With P, I, and D, and each of the calculated tuning values as arguments. So in my case, I'll send it M301, P12.6, I0.66, D60.6 for my E3D hot end. If you're also using an E3D hot end, you can use those values as a basis. You can then go and try these shiny new PID tunings on a print. Marlin will use them until the next time you disconnect from the printer. Now, that was for tuning a hot end. If you want to use PID for your heated bed, there's one more option you need to the M303 command, and that is E for extruder. The heated bed is extruder -1. The first hot end is 0, the second hot end is 1, and so on. To set the values, you'll need to have PID enabled for the heated bed in Marlin's configuration, and you can then use M304 instead of M301 with the same arguments as for an hot end. By the way, if you have more than one hot end, Marlin will use the same PID tunings for each of them, no matter which one you used for autotune. To make settings permanent, you can either send a simple M500 command to the printer, which will make Marlin load up the values you just set with M301 or M304 each time you power up the printer. You can also change the values in Marlin's configuration files and then re-upload the whole firmware. So that's all there is to it. Autotune is a one-time process and can really improve your prints, so if you haven't autotuned your printer yet, do it now. That's it for today. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe.